In this video, Trey's looking at which stocks are really in play at the moment when it comes to the coronavirus in terms of vaccination, in terms of PPE equipment. Stay tuned. Hey guys, warm welcome to you. All right, so lots of stocks in play at the moment. Obviously, everyone's rushing to produce a vaccination. If you're a biotech company, everyone's rushing to produce PPE equipment, mandatory masks in certain areas, PPE equipment to protect workers, frontline workers, general workers who are interacting with the public. So there's a big kind of gold rush, if you like, by these companies who try to take advantage of this demand by governments and by the public for coronavirus related services and products, if you want to put it that way. But anyway, you know, if we look at it from a trading perspective, let's kind of put everything to one side in terms of the coronavirus, because I'm sure, like you, like me, you've had enough of all the media and all the bits and pieces that are going on about it. Let's just stick to trading. Let's just see what's moving and where the opportunities are for us. Okay, so vaccine plays. We've got NVAX. Now, NVAX, one thing to say about these vaccine plays, guys, is that, hey, you know, the chances of any of them coming out with a vaccine are low. Now, that's just not me speculating. That's just based on history. If you look at Zika, if you look at Ebola, look at all that kind of stuff, the odds of a company coming out with a vaccine that works and pass all the tests and all that kind of stuff is historically low. Now, will that change because of changing legislation and changing the fact that governments are desperate under any circumstances to get a vaccine? Maybe it will. But anyway, again, what the point is, guys, is that you've got to be very careful of the binary event with vaccination companies or biotech companies. Same with any biotech companies that come out with a new drug, they're coming out with, you know, something. It's either all or nothing. It's either a blockbuster and it's going to make them a lot of money, or it's going to fail. So companies like NVAX have rallied aggressively since mid-March from kind of $10 level to almost $60 now. In fact, it's $63 pre-market by the time doing this, so we're well above highs. We've got companies as well like INO. Same kind of thing, a pharmaceutical company here ripping up. It's come, you know, got a real aggressive rip. I mean, that went crazy and then backed off a little bit. And we've got mRNA, saying these are the vaccination type, you know, plays out there. But you got to be careful with those, because at any moment they could say, yes, we're past the trial, onto the next phase, which is give the company a bid, or, oh, you know what, we struggle with that, we're gonna have to go back to the drawing board. And because there's something like 100 companies all trying to get this vaccine at once, you could be on the wrong end of this. So be aware, if you are playing these type of companies like INO and NVAX and mRNA, I'm sure there's some others out there, just be aware that, you know, any one day you could see a halving. I mean, you just look at this company, look at this stock here, it's up at $20. By the end of the day, you know, it's down at 10. So if you're playing these, be aware that the risk reward is high. If you're on the right end of it, great, you're gonna make a lot of money. If you're on the wrong end of it, you're gonna lose a lot of money. So just be cautious of playing those games. The other one, guys, is obviously the PPE equipment. So Lake do a lot of PPE equipment. They rallied aggressively and fell back sharply. And that seems to be the kind of pattern that we often get with these companies. A lot of hype, a lot of demand coming in for the stock, ripping it up, especially in a small cap stock when you're talking the average kind of trade value of, sorry, the average volume is done is less than a million. All of a sudden, a lot of people coming in moves the price aggressively, and that's when we get this aggressive move, and of course it pulling back and we see it back and kind of settles into a mean. And that, you know, seems like a more fair valuation, if you dare say that, and that's probably sacrilege for a price action trader to say a fair valuation. We get the point. You know, we stretch out, the mean would suggest the $15 is about right for this, based on fresh news and fresh demand for PPE equipment. You know, so you get the spike up, you get the mean reversion back, and we get gaps like this as well, so being mindful of that. The other one we're looking at, guys, is APT. You know, these guys are face masks, mandatory face masks coming out in California. Big rip from these into the close. Now, we're still within this range, but it's a big range. Let's be honest, it's a big range. Same kind of thing came out with same kind of pattern as on some of the others like Lakeland. The big spike up and then a kind of mean reversion back, but still holding pretty high after where they were before. So, you know, you've got to be mindful of these. You've got to be careful that they are literally news-based. And if someone comes out and says, hey, you know, we're not demanding face masks anymore, and they're a face mask company, then they're going to get hammered. If they come out and more states and more countries go, yes, we are having mandatory face masks and we're having this and that and the other, all of a sudden you know there's a demand for their product. Now, whether they choose this company or not doesn't really matter so much, because the chances of them producing more and making more money comes higher, the stock is going to become more highly valued. And of course, you've got to look out, guys, at some of the short selling interest on these. I know that APT has got a high short set, high short interest, so it could create a bit of a short squeeze if you get a continued press. If you get a spike and a reversal, very often you might get a few who get who kind of get chucked out of the trade, but it's the continued press and hold that is more painful for shorts, because they have to sit to the mark to market every day. You know, this was in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you could sit through it and you had the margin for it, then you're going to have still a lot of short sellers who are in it. If, however, it's constantly building a bid, building a bid, building a bid, short sellers may well have to go to market and buy to cover the short, causing the fuel and the squeeze higher. So be mindful of the binary outcome of trading these kind of things, guys. You've got the PPE equipment stocks, you've got the diagnostic stocks, you've got the vaccination stocks, you've got all these which are plays around the virus, but also, but bear in mind, they are news related, they are news driven, they are highly speculative. You've got to be very nimble with them, but you know, there are some good opportunities there as well if these are your type of things and you're prepared to take the risk that comes with them. Just watch out for these kind of extreme spikes and back off, you know, news-based spikes, especially on the thinner stuff, like in less than a million average daily volume is probably a good metric to go, right, you know what, that's a smaller stock, I need to be careful and mindful. That could really, really squeeze if we had a bit of good news or bad news. Anyway, guys, take care. See you next one. Keep your risk managed. Bye-bye.